Let's say that you want wall light outside your home that should be automatic. Then we will need the assembly like this. At the top of the assembly, we will have our solar plate which charges the internal battery. At the bottom side, we want a sensor that detects object. And the top of the side panel, we will have our LED strip. This LED strip will glow in the darkness. As a demo, we will use the IR sensor to detect the object. The star of this video is LM358 dual op-amp IC. Pins 1, 2, 3 are op-amp 1, pins 8 and 4 are power supply, which requires a voltage between 3 volt to 32 volt. Pins 5, 6, 7 are op-amp 2. We will use op-amp 1 for automatic light and op-amp 2 for IR sensor. For that, I created this small schematic on the Easy EDA online software. Like before, we have with us LM358. The two outputs of IC are combined together and use a BC547 NPN transistor to act as a switch to turn on the LED strip. As the pin number 3 is non-inverting terminal, the LDR is connected to it, whose resistance increases in darkness and decreases in brightness. The R1 and R2 are the two potentiometers to vary the voltage. The voltage of the R1 must be greater than R2, otherwise the LED strip won't glow. Suppose the voltage of R1 is 2.8 volt and 2.6 for the R2. When there is brightness, the resistance of the LDR will be small and all the current will flow through the LDR straight to the ground, and the resultant output is off. In the darkness, the resistance of the LDR will be highest, then the voltage at non-inverting terminal is greater, hence LED strip will glow. Now this is the circuit of IR sensor. The LED strip will glow when there is an object detected. I will make another video in detail to see how IR sensor works. After this theory part, I made the list of all components, and after soldering on a pref board of about half an hour, I have this simple looking PCB with an outside LDR. A 4 volt 1A battery with a toggle switch soldered on the positive terminal. A 4 volt LED strip with 20 lights. A small solar panel with a 1N4007 diode on a positive terminal. Now we just have to assemble and connect all the components. Glue the LED strip like this and solder the battery's terminal on the circuit. After making all the connections, check the wall light by changing the preset value. As a demo, I have used only one IR transmitter. To increase the range, you should use two or more than two IR transmitters. Well, as always, thanks for watching and do subscribe to my channel.